Hey y'all, welcome back to Magic Knight Rayearth. I can't think of anything that starts with TH for Thursday, but I have a good one for tomorrow, so be excited for that. So before I proceed, I am going to jump into the world map here and go exploring a little bit. There are at least 3 spots that I want to try smashing my way through. Right, so the X button. I forgot to explain when I redid the part that I lost. I thought how it was going to work was you press the X button to dash and your character just runs straight forward like a spin dash in Sonic or Link in A Link to the Past would be a more apt comparison. But you have to actually physically move long enough to build up your speed. So I speculated that I'll get another ability in the future that lets me just instantly start running without having to build up the speed first, and that's probably what the X button is for. Pulverizing bash, smash through weak structures. Alright, so is there enough space here for me to actually... Excellent. Aha! A heart container. Alright, Fu, you deserve a treat. After your character growth from the previous episode. Okay. Maybe I should check in on Sarah and... What's-his-face? Has Sarah's house been magically rebuilt? That would be good. I would like her to have her own place. Aw, there's like a memorial here now. This is Jiminy's grave, isn't it? Aw, that's sweet. Thanks, I know. I've made up my mind. I'll become Sarah's friend, and we can play together. Aww. Dun dun dun. Aw, I can't jump back into the water from there. Ah, such fond memories. This is where we learned to swim. This is where we found a dragon. This is where a creepy guy yelled at us. Oh, look at this place. Wait, no, this is the wrong place. I've heard that Kaltus has returned to his old house in this village. He's become the caregiver of a child. That's not what you say when that happens. I hope he's become the caregiver of a child. Oh, look at this place. You cleaned up nice, Kaltus. Sarah living with me is not a problem, but this style of interior decoration has got to go. Yeah. It was way better before. Yeesh. Oh, thank God. She has her own bed, and there's a wall separating her from Kaltus. Not that I'm implying anything for Kaltus, you know? He doesn't seem bad. I just want Sarah to be comfortable. How can men put up with such a filthy house? I couldn't take it, so I cleaned up a room. Well, isn't it pretty? It is. It has also been made to look great. Oh, it is emerald green. Well, the drawers are. I thought they were talking about the box on top, and I was like, that doesn't look green. Thank you. Yeah, no man has ever thought about a flower. Kind of a creepy looking portrait over the fireplace. Happy ending. Alright, good job, Sarah. Take care of yourself, and call us if you need anything. Alright, well, I think that's the last of my business in Taflon by the sea. The only reason I can remember the name of this town, and not the others, is that it sounds like Teflon. That's weird. The ice village is called Rosen, I think. I don't remember what the windy village is called, but I'm going back there. Polizu, that's right. Italian for police, maybe. I'll commit that to memory. I'll just think of a police officer with a big curly mustache. Wonder if anyone's moved in to Countess's old place. Nope, just an abandoned house. I mean, Sarah could move in there, clean that place up, and have a place of her own to live. But I suppose that's not in the cards. Right, that's just the item shop. So I want to go this way and then south, I think. So if I keep going east, that'll take me back to the rainbow shop. Oh, no, this is a different kind of barrier. I can't smash my way through that. At least I don't think I can. I don't believe my momentum would carry with me from off screen, even if I could build it up in this area. Maybe that's something for when I get my X dash ability. Yeah, your momentum does not carry over. Alright, well, that's all I wanted to check on here, really. I thought there was one more thing. Was there anything in the Whispering Woods? I remember this being a dead end of some sort. But I don't remember why it was a dead end. I don't think it was a smashable barrier, but it never hurts to check. Alright. No arguments there. Right. Yeah, I seem to remember making my way through this clearing, and then it was just a big empty field? I don't remember there being anything else of note. Yeah, nothing smashable, at least. Unless there's some other hidden path through these trees. Ah. I cast a magic spell to let me see the forest's true nature, but it still doesn't actually show me where the paths are. Oh well. It was worth a shot. Alright, just pick a few cabbages, and then I will be on my way. So what else was there? I don't remember anything around Preach's Manor, but it might be a good idea to see how she's doing. Check in with Preacha. Haven't talked to her in a while. Well, technically, I just heard from her in the mysterious Sephiro lecture, but I think that might be beyond the fourth wall. You know, she was talking to me, not the Magic Knights. You have found Ceres. I think you three should continue east through the area of high volcanic activity. Perhaps there is a machine hidden there. Yeah, that's what I was thinking earlier. I'm curious why the game seems to want me to progress forward when I was expecting to find a machine inside that cave. Alright, nothing happened in here. I suppose I'll press onward. I do kind of want to try to get to that other cave again. The one way to the right. Yeah, just leave the stage out. It'll be fine. Alright, I want to try, like, jumping. Like, jumping for my life. That did not work. That worked 0%. Maybe that's another situation where I will need whatever ability is on the X button. That dash attack. Not like a secret passage of some sort, is there? No. Well, actually going through this guy's house would probably be faster. Rafarga is his name. No. All right, well, whatever. Warm and gushy. Alright, let's smash up some ice. I got up to full speed without the other two on the screen. So it is possible. Just wasn't working that one time for some reason. I hope I'm not referring to something that was in the lost footage. Uh-oh. This music's loud. So that is the Escudo level 2 attack on Fu. Yeah, this is like dominating my headphones. Present. Alright. That's not the color I still needed. I still need indigo. Sorry, I was just checking something. Alright, so that looks like something I probably shouldn't touch. Oh god. Oh no. So many freaking attacks. Like, I love you, Fu, but come on. Oh god, it blew up. Okay. I'm okay. So, Hikaru has Escudo level 2, so she will probably be my best melee attacker for right now. Alright, come on. Excellent. Indigo? Orange? Can I jump that? Do I need, like, a burst of speed to jump over there? Yeah, that definitely does not look jumpable. I don't think having more speed would help. I don't know, I might. Alright, come on. Come on! Get up. Thank you. I forgot what an obnoxious process that is. Okay. Yeah, that didn't do squat. But I can jump down. I can jump down here, probably. And over here. And up here. Ah, that's still so many hits. I don't know, maybe Umi will be better because she's the water element. And water is strong against fire. Making a different sound effect. But that might just be the sound her sword makes. Also, I'm not a fan of the way that thing poops lava. Alright, is it... It's gotta be possible to build up speed here, right? Build up enough speed to break through those rocks. Alright. Ah! Boy, I hope I get that stationary dash ability soon. I don't remember getting far enough in the game to unlock anything like that. And I don't know if that's because I didn't, or if I'm just not remembering that I did. Come on. Ugh. Yeah, if I, like, change directions at all, I lose momentum. But I lose momentum if I turn around, too. Ah! Okay, I think this is my best shot. Like, this long stretch here. Mmm! Oh, this sucks. Oh, that's not even a thing? Oh. Awesome. Foo. Speaking of magic, so I have enough maximum MP to cast that 3 times now. That's nice. Well, I'm not fighting these things again. That's for dang sure. Yeah, don't know how to get over there. It might require an ability that I don't have. Ow! Oh my god, that is too many fire. Go away. Oh, that sucked. I'll take my chances with the death pit. Maybe I can clear the fireballs off the screen with Umi's spell. I mean, that's still going to be a lot of fireballs. Oh, wow. Oh, maybe I can just attack them. Ah, okay. Now I'm in the volcano. Oh, so those lava pits spit fireballs. They don't turn into lava monsters. Okay, well, I feel like Umi was the best at dealing with this thing. Maybe there is an elemental opposite thing going on here. I don't know. Maybe I'm imagining things. Alright, that's just a... No? So I can't attack it until it actually turns into the monster. Yeah, I think that was about the same amount of time. That's a bummer. They don't even drop anything. I'm holding off on my healing spell for now. I can take at least another hit, and there might be a fountain nearby. Yellow. Yellow. I mean, theoretically, Hikaru's magic. I probably need to use a charge attack with one of these two. The normal attack probably does the same amount of damage. Okay, that was noticeably faster, but Hikaru's level 2 attack is probably the strongest thing I have right now. Not against those blocks, though. Alright, so Hikaru's wide sweep on her sword is probably the best thing to deal with these fireballs. Oh god. Nah! Okay. They come back. Thank you for exploding. Don't look at me, creeps. Hey. Indigo? Green. I don't know why I'm fighting this thing, really. Just something to do. Just a way to pass the time. Some nice sword hacking. Oh, come on. Indigo. Excellent. As soon as I make my way through this dungeon, I will hit up the world map. That's probably time for a heal. Alright, everyone's full up. Excellent. It's kind of extra insulting. That's a bit of a strong word, but I don't know what other word works. It's kind of extra insulting that they refer to this game as an action RPG. Like, it says action RPG right on the box, when it's not, it's an action adventure game. But it's kind of extra insulting because the action's not really that good. And if there was some sort of RPG element, that would make it more fun. But there isn't really. Like, allocating staff points, that's not really role-playing. I mean, it can be an element of role-playing. Okay. So are some of the men of Rosen still working for Caldina? Oh. No, this village is just on fire. Aye, it's burning up. Well, if you go through that cave, there's fire in there too, so that won't be much help. Well, there's lava, which is a form of fire. I know what to do here. No magic zone. Oh. Hello. Sure. Slurp. Yeah, your house. That's what you should be worrying about, and not dying. Oh, the fire is enchanted. It can't be extinguished with water. Okay, so Umi couldn't help anyway. Well, the thing about Princess Emerald is... Okay, everyone sit down. I have to tell you about the legend of the Magic Knights. Nothing important is going on, right? You're all good for story time. I mean, this fire doesn't seem particularly urgent. Okay, that does seem urgent. Let's see. Nope. Ah! Flaming mice. Oh, I think that thing just exploded on its own. I saw a key. Huh. Okay. Well, now that... Oh. I can attack the fire? Oh. Maybe not? Oh, I see the thing that it dropped. Oh, this doesn't hurt. Okay. But I also can't open this door. Well, that's nice of them not to make the fire hurt. Water! Okay. That looks like it can be jumped. Yeah. It can totally be jumped. Okay, so the doors have different playing card suits on them. Well, sort of. Okay, I'm on the other side of the chandelier now. I don't know why these rats are coming after me. I didn't start the fire. It's always been burning since the world's been turning. I mean, I didn't light it, but I'll try to fight it. Found a strange blue key. Opens blue doors. Hey Club, do you have any advice for this situation? Yeah, that's what I thought. Well, what do you mean? I mean that the forces opposing the Magic Knights have set this trap just for you. Oh no, we're in danger. Again. I'm in danger. Okay, that's impassable. Oh, that thing's spawning the fire rats. I see. It's like a monster generator from Gauntlet. And when it goes away, it turns into more fire rats. Well, that's a lesson I had to learn the hard way. Well, now you all see why I've been putting all my points into Foo. Alright, well, I have the blue key, so... Wasn't there another spade door on this side of the chandelier somewhere? I don't know, maybe not. I know it's more like an upside down blue heart, but... close enough. Alright. Stop and admire the paintings. The time for it. Well, that fire still burns. What's this? Oh, just decoration. Weird. Okay. Well, there's some water, but I've learned that water doesn't help. But I can jump in the tub? Why? That's very odd. I don't know, maybe I come back to this location later. Oh, there's the red key. Or the heart key. Back off, man. I got a bow. Very carefully collect the useless money. Ah, forget it. Alright, well, I suppose now I gotta go up the stairs and back around. Man, this place sucks. I don't like being inside burning buildings. Especially when there's fire rats everywhere. None of the fire safety training I ever had prepared me for fire rats. Aha! Alright, that's all the keys, right? Red, blue, and green. Those are the three colors. RBG. Or is it RGB? I can never remember which color comes next in the acronym. Like, I know red's first. I can never remember if it's BG or GB. GB is Game Boy. But the Game Boy was black and white. Or I guess it was green and other green. So that doesn't help as far as the mnemonic goes. RBG is Ruth Bader Ginsburg. Who was a colorful character? I don't know. I mean, not that it actually matters. Aw, that door was just gonna collapse anyway? I got that green key for nothing. What a ripoff. I see a small child who needs my help. That fire is not harmless like all the other fire. Alright, Pooh. Don't let me down. I mean, I can switch to... Oh, God. Okay. I can switch to the other two. Would you please stop, for the love of God? Ugh. Yeah, let's stick with Hikaru for a minute. Oh! Well, that's a relief. Aw, man. I saw the kid and I thought I was done. Okay, I guess I did need the green key after all. I'm glad smoke inhalation isn't a thing with magic fire. That would be extremely inconvenient for the magic knights. Oh God. Ha 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 ha, I see you finally arrived, magic knight wannabes. Alcyone, this evil suits you well. I'm not surprised you would use children to further your agenda. I will use whatever means necessary to prove my worth to Zagat once more. Your victory in our last encounter dishonored not only me, but Zagat as well. Didn't Zagat turn you into a block of ice? I'm here to prove that your luck has run out and reclaim what you stole from me. The desperate never win. You're grasping at straws, you pasty-faced freak. Excuse me, but didn't you command only ice magic when last we engaged? How did you... Never underestimate the power of pure evil. I shall claim the crown of Emerald, or die. Oh, please. Can you spout a few more cliches? I think I'm going to be sick. I'm just calling it as I see it. Got a problem with that? What does that mean? I command you to tell me. Who? Umi is scaring me. So, because I have the text speed set to instant, I think I'm missing some of the dialogue boxes. Because some of them are like scripted, not to require a button press. So those are just displaying instantly and then disappearing. But assume Umi just said something very scary. Oh god, I've been going for 40 minutes. He does seem to be particularly nasty right now, but perhaps it will work to our advantage. The time for words is past. This skank will be your executioner. Your death will finally prove my love to Zagat. Goodbye, children. This is probably fine. Okay, this has been Thursday's episode. Tune in tomorrow for the Flaming Skull Battle. Bye, everyone.